Hello viewers. Let's develop guess the number game. This game and the logic is very simple. You play the game with computer. The computer randomly chooses a number in a specified range. And you try to guess that number. Let's first take a look how this program will look and work at the end. I am using a background picture and a menu. The computer will randomly chooses a number in the range of 1 to 20. In this text box you are only allowed to write integers. Text box will not accept any other character. But backspace is allowed. You cannot leave the text box empty and you cannot paste anything in the text box. That means we have disabled the right click on the text box. In this tutorial you will not only learn how to develop this game, but you will learn how to apply strict text box validation so that your program won't crash under any circumstances. Let's begin the development. I am using this image as a background image. You can design your own image using your favorite image editor. Now open a Windows form application. We will fix our form first. Adjust form size to 550 into 400. Copy and paste size values into maximum size and minimum size properties of form. Now apply background image. Now we need some controls on the form. On your screen you can find all the controls we need and their property values. So pause the video here and design your interface accordingly. Okay, our interface is ready and it is time to code. The first thing we will do is to validate input in the text box. We will only allow user to write numbers and use backspace in the text box. Let's attach a key press event to the text box. Now quote an if statement and say, if user is pressing a character that is not a digit, then remove that character. I hope you understand this code. Otherwise I can explain a bit. Our text box is attached to a key press event handler. Key press event handler has key press event args object which provides data when user press a key. Character that a user is pressing not being placed directly into the text box. Every character received by the key char property of key press event args and then it is placed into the text box. And here by using if statement we are interrupting key char property and checking every character against the digit. If character is not a digit, then we are setting the handled property to true and it will simply remove the character from the key char before it appears into the text box. Now we will allow backspace. Run the program and check if we are getting desired results. Text box is working fine and accepting only digits and backspace. But we can copy and paste anything into the text box. Because we are controlling the keys but not clipboard. For example, what we can do here is to disable right click onto the text box. In order to disable right-click menu we will use a trick. That is, we will create an empty right-click menu and assign it to our text box. For creating a right-click menu we usually use context menu strip. You can find a whole tutorial in the channel. where I am describing how to generate right-click menu. Let's program it. Create a context menu strip object. Create a form load event. Assign context menu strip to the text box. Now run the program. Right-click menu will not appear when user right-clicks on the text box. Actually, right-click is not disabled here. We have just assigned an empty right-click menu to our text box. This is a simple technique you can use whenever you want to disable right-click menu on any control. Now attach the button and program simple logic of guessing number. The first thing we need to do is to generate a random number in the range of 1 to 20. Now read the data from the text box and check simultaneously if the user leaving the text box empty. Now control for if user enters number in the specified range. Now write the if statement that matches the numbers. Make text box read only and disable the button so that user cannot continue the game. Let's try and check if all the if statements working properly or not. Now we will program the progress bar. I am giving the user 10 turns. Declare a variable named turns. Initialize it with 100 under form load. The value of turns variable is subtracted by 10 when user makes a guess. And we assign new value to progress bar. Run the program and check if progress bar is working fine. It is fine. Now we will write a if statement and will say, if value of turn is equal to 0, then user has no turn left and game is over. Check if it's working. Let's program game menu now. Add play again and exit options into menu strip. Double click on exit option. It will create an event handler and write the code. double-click on Play Again option and write the code. Here we will reset everything and give initial values to variables and controls. Now run the program and double check if everything is working fine. As you have noticed that we have some code that repeats itself. Why not write a method instead and call it where needed? Let's write it a method. We have done with the code now. Give a final run and check if everything is working fine. I hope you liked this tutorial and learned some new things. Thanks for watching.